Big Daddy.
Bam. But I'm a whore and I took the money. Now I'm on my way. A 4-hour Harlem. The doctor told my wife I had stuff floating around in my brain. And my wife went, yeah?
Better step back, Sam. It's Big Daddy Graham.
I looked at him as like the fan's voice overnight after a game, somebody that would tell you that was a great game or that was a clunker or Larry Brown's got to do a better job or Allen or Billy King's got to make a trade. To me, that was the big thing about Big Daddy.
I just want to tell you, if Big Daddy Graham could have his way, he wouldn't be paying to see this show because he was cheap.
He had the hiccups for days. Who does that happen to?
He told a joke at an event. Howard Eskin was the punchline.
You're Big J.O. now. Get out of my face.
Yeah, hello, boss. Yeah, this is Big Daddy, and I can't make it in today. You see, my grandmother died yesterday.
He was the easiest person in the world to prank. You could literally tell him he was wearing no clothes, and he'd look down and say, oh, my God, I'm not.
Big Daddy was a weekly guest on our Sports Connection show. And he opened, for whatever reason, was Big Daddy in a swimsuit, coming out of the Atlantic Ocean in all his glory.
He was always seemed like he was disheveled, like, you know, you knew, like, when he went to his car, he had no idea where his car keys were. And so he's gonna be looking for that, and probably had a sandwich on his arm where he's trying to get in the car, spilling coffee on himself. Because, and then he didn't care if he was going to somewhere and he had coffee or food on him because he's like, hey, I'm Big Daddy, I can do whatever I want.
I'm not exactly sure why we had to have Big Daddy in a bathing suit coming out of the Atlantic Ocean.
I reached out to Big Daddy Graham. I said, hey, can you help us? He said, sure, come on down to the WIP studio. I got the perfect spot to shoot this.
Big Daddy Graham was a large pain in my ass.
I followed him around a corner. He sat down on the crapper and said, hey, I'm sitting exactly at the spot of where I think of your show.
Oh. Oh. I was a shop steward at WIP, and he would call me every single year in October and ask me the same damn question. Is Columbus Day an after holiday?
He did this thing called the snack of the night, and I'd always hear it either driving in or driving home. This is what you heard. All you heard was paper wrapping, and you hear his lips smacking on radio, and he described whatever he was eating, and it made me smile, it made me laugh, it made me hungry.
Next time any of you folks are getting your picture taken for your license, smile to the camera and go like this.
When you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
and the whole world smiles with you.
Smiles.
And when you're laughing,
when you're laughing,
oh, you're laughing,
oh, you're laughing.
Mm. When the sun comes shining through.
We ended up here at 7025 Elwin Avenue. Our driveway, it's some sort of weird, bizarre piece of crap concrete throughway, right? Is that what you would call this? If you did own a car, you couldn't put it in the garage because it's so steep it ripped out the bottom of your engine. Paul got hit 40 years ago. As a result, our entire kitchen was always on a little slant. That's why I can say, I'm from the hood. That, my friends, is a trolley. So I ended up only in the closet for like a half hour because they couldn't take me screaming anymore. Roll with me here now. How many people had their own swim club right across the street from their house? Guess how much it costs to be a member of this swim club? Nothing. Police station's right on the other side. Locked up 4 times in this baby, but no slammer could keep me.
I tell him my name is Joe Drunk. That one, the cop goes, you drunk? This is my wife, Debbie Drunk. The kids were all drunk. We're the drunk family.
And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain.
I'm gonna take this bite in honor of Big Daddy Graham. Get a couple smacks in here, like he did. Rub the paper. Big Daddy Graham, a treat for all of us who will never forget. God bless you, man. God bless you all.
To say the things he truly feels.
He was the ultimate scam artist. You know what? I don't miss those empty one-way conversations one bit. I lied. I love Big Daddy. I love you. I miss him.
And not the words of one who kneels. The record shows I took the blows and did it my way.
Hey, my name's Big Daddy Graham. That was so much fun.
Yes, it was mine.